Is this seat taken?
I'm not looking for company.
You're in Paris, my friend. In this city, no one drinks alone. So, what are we celebrating?
We, Art. But if you're keen to get your teeth kicked in, I'd be happy to oblige.
I'd have thought you were too busy kicking yourself. With good reason, I'm sure.
What's it to you?
You think you're the only man in Paris hoping to drown a guilty conscience? This city is filled with men like us. We all have good reasons. I've been watching you these past weeks. I have seen that you have no love for the Nazis. The question is, how many more people will die at the hands of these jackbooted killers while you sit there cowering like a whipped dog? You're mad enough to break that bottle over my head, but you won't lift a finger to help these people, eh?
This isn't my country.
Oh, did you abandon your conscience at the border? Does the need for justice end at some line drawn on a map?
Aye, if it's a map of Ireland, you Frenchmen have unrealistic expectations.
Open your eyes! The war is all around us. You can't escape it. You can hide here and leave the fighting to braver men. Or you can walk out that door and do what must be done. The choice is yours!
Keep it down. That sort of talk will get us both a bullet in the back of the head.
I intend to do more than talk. There is a courtyard around the corner. Meet me there when you are ready to stop hiding. I see you're a man who'd rather die on his feet than live on his knees.
I'd rather the Krauts did the dying.
Excellent. There is a German fuel depot down the street. 5,000 barrels of precious petrol, guarded by a handful of half-drunk supply clerks.
Sounds like one hell of a fire hazard.
My thoughts exactly.
We'll need something to get the fireworks started.
I know a place where we can get what we need. But first, I must know. Are you prepared to kill if necessary?
Oui, I see it. These Nazi bastards bought their own tickets to hell. I'm just laying out the welcome mat.
That's my car there.
I'll drive.
Let's get moving.
Where are we headed?
I spotted a German supply cache nearby. I am sure they won't mind if we borrow a few things, eh? Have you ever handled explosives before?
I handled a bombshell once. Turned out she was married.
Is he serious?
All right, keep your knickers on. I know what I'm doing.
I had a feeling you would. Merde, look at these fucking Nazis everywhere, infesting my beautiful city like cockroaches.
They certainly made themselves at home.
It's time we showed them a different kind of hospitality.
Thank you.
supply caches down that alley. Let's go. Look at those spineless jackals. I can't stand it anymore.
Whoa, steady, mate. Let's just get what we came for.
Espèce d'enfoiré du merde!
Christ, here we go.
What's all that about?
Not now. Let's go. The crates are up there, but we need to be careful. This supply cache is a restricted area.
Oh, aye. Was that you being careful back in the alley?
I lost my temper. It won't happen again.
See that it doesn't. I didn't leave a nice warm bar just to get my head blown off.
If we are spotted near the crates, the Germans will attempt to sound the alarm.
Then we'll have to get rid of that lookout first.
Yes, you should be able to find hand and footholds on the surface of that building. Climb up there and throw that Nazi piece of shit from the roof while I move in on the ground. Can you do that?
It's a piece of piss.
I do not know this phrase.
It means yes. Let's get to it, guys.
Tell me, Irishman. We cannot allow them to sound the alarm.
Seine Flanke ist offen.
You are welcome to our second class. Into the Heights. Please register at the German political office.
Now let's see what kind of party favors these krauts brought for us.
Break open those crates. Those explosives will do nicely. Just remember to save at least one charge for the fuel depot. Let's get back to the car.
I'm anxious to get the real show started.
Most men would have lost their nerve by now. Tell me, my friend, what were you doing in Ireland before you came to my country?
I was a mechanic, not that it's any of your business.
A mechanic, eh? Well, the resistance could use a good mechanic.
I didn't know there was a resistance in Paris.
That's about to change. After tonight, the Nazis will have a new enemy to fear. The depot is just up ahead.
We'll need to create a diversion to get past that gate.
The Nazis are trained to investigate the sound of gunshots or an explosion. Use that to your advantage. 10 pounds of high explosive on that truck should get their attention.
Aye, that'll do.
Start by climbing that building. Once you're on the roof, keep your head down and wait until the truck explodes. Then, use that telephone wire to cross the street into the fuel depot. While the soldiers are distracted, move in quickly and place a charge on the primary storage tank.
I'll meet you by the gate when it's done.
Watch your ass, Irishman.
Thank you.
time to leg it. Oh, fuck me.
Did is blow up a petrol station.
Though I must admit it,
that fireball did make a pretty picture.
You are wrong, Irishman. Something has changed. It is in the air. Can you not feel it?
Well, now that you mention it.
It is just the beginning. We will push back the darkness, free the city from fear, house by house, street by street. Get some rest, my friend. We will have much to do in the days ahead.
Oh, aye. If by that you mean a sweet brunette and a glass of whiskey.
Enjoy your reward, Irishman. You earned it. I owe you a drink.
What's got into you, mate?
What the hell are you doing?
What's it bloody look like?
The Aurora is my girl now, Sean. I will not have another man picking up her skirt.
Oh, for fuck's sake, Jules.
You're a driver now. You want respect on the circuit? You gotta stop thinking like a mechanic.
All right, I'm put on airs like some posh wanker with a silver spoon up me arse. No thanks, brother.
Veronique!
Morning, beautiful.
I'm coming along for the race. Vittore asked me to take pictures.
Couldn't he wait till I'd made myself a little more decent?
I don't believe in miracles.
Oh, my sister got all the charm.
And the brains.
That's enough screwing around. We've got a race to win. You boys have work to do. Both of you.
Say the word, boss.
Let's get our girl on the trailer. I want to be across the border by sundown.
Oh,
Ready to move out?
The truck is loaded and ready to roll.
And the Aurora?
Trussed up tighter than a nun's arse.
Good. Veronique and I will ride ahead. You boys take the truck and head east to the German border. From there, it's a straight shot to Saarbrücken. I've marked the location on your map.
Come on, Sean, get in.
Yeah.
That's it, my friend. After tomorrow, you'll be a famous driver, and I will be right there beside you, reaping the rewards of your success.
Which rewards did you have in mind?
The women! These German girls are crazy for racers. We'll have a dozen blonde beauties feeding us grapes, huh? Assuming you don't fuck it up, of course.
Well, I appreciate the vote of confidence, Jules, but there's more riding on this race than you getting your hull knocked off. Vittori took a big gamble making me his wheel man.
You're not gonna let him down, Sean.
I hope not.
Vittori's got bigger problems to worry about these days.
Like what?
Like the fact that a war could break out any minute, huh? Don't you read the papers?
Just the sports section.
These Nazi bastards are itching for a fight. If they get their wish, we're all gonna be out of a job. The border up ahead. Drive slow and try not to look suspicious.
Right. I should have warned me Lederhosen.
I'm serious. These assholes are looking for any excuse to start shooting. Thank you kindly.
Not much farther now. I can smell the petrol fumes from here.
You just keep your eyes on the track and the pedal to the floor, my friend. You let me worry about the race.
You volunteering to be me manager?
What's so funny? I didn't have to be a mechanic, you know. I could have done anything. The teacher used to say to me, Jules, all of these kids are stupid, especially your cousin Javier. But not usual. You are too clever for your own good.
I thought Veronique got the brains in the family.
She likes to think so.
What's her beef with me anyway? I can't put a foot right when she's around.
It's not just you. Veronique is tough on men in general.
Why's that?
One of these days I'll take you to my family's cabaret in Paris, huh? Veronique was raised in the Belle de Nuit. Let's just say it was not your typical upbringing.
Sounds like fun.
My friend, you have no idea. I'll meet you at the bar.
First round's on me.
I'm glad you finally decided to join us.
We took the scenic routes.
You run into any trouble?
Just the usual groupies, looking for autographs.
A toast to Team Morini and Our Lady Aurora.
To Signor Morini, for taking a big chance on a dodgy bloke like me. Another round for me mates.
Easy, Sean. You'll need a clear head tomorrow. Dirker flew in this morning from Berlin.
Kurt Dirker? I thought he was retired.
Speak of the devil.
Guten Abend, Herr Morini. Always a pleasure to welcome one of our Italian friends to the fatherland. I was just speaking of my admiration for General Mussolini. A kindred spirit to our own Führer. Your country is fortunate to have such a leader, yeah?
Racing is my passion. I find little time for politics.
Sometimes racing is politics.
No, there is a difference.
You must forgive my ignorance, Herr Morini. We Germans are a simple people. Perhaps you would enlighten us further?
One's a hobby for rich assholes who can't get laid without a flashy car and a silly uniform. The other is racing.
This must be that British mechanic who thinks he's a driver.
I'm fucking Irish.
It's getting late. Why don't we call it a night?
The night is young, Fräulein. Stay, dine with me.
I've no taste for German cuisine.
Not yet, perhaps. But soon, the women of your country will learn to savor the taste of a purebred German bratwurst.
Bastard! Let's get my crazy sister out of here before she gets herself killed!
I am not going anywhere!
Enough! I'm taking her upstairs!
Hans! Hans! Nein! And stay the fuck down!
I don't think you can hear me.
Ricardo, you Nazi freak.
Easy, mate. Save some for me.
Taste your blood, mechanic.
To the police. I'll take care of Veronique.
You boy, get out of here.
Jules, time to get scarce.
Right behind you.
Are you chatting me up? Hello, Sean. Hi, Jules.
Meld. We'll catch up later. Right now, we need to borrow your car.
Well, so much for awkward small talk.
Drive the fucking car!
Hold on to your arses. Just like old times, eh, Skyler?
Never a dull moment. How long have you been in town?
Just got in, actually.
I see you wasted no time running afoul of the local police.
Ugh, those fellas behind us, they're just having a laugh.
Is this desperado routine meant to be a turn-on?
I don't know. Is it working?
Will you watch the fucking road, please?
The radio ahead to set up roadblocks. Double back and you should be able to slip through the net.
I teach you that in your posh English school.
Benefits of a higher education.
All English girls as crazy as you are.
Give us a bit of privacy, would you, Jules?
Oh, I'd love to, as soon as you check these crowds.
I'm parched.
Fuck this. I'm not going to be the third wheel. Take me back to the hotel.
Hmm.
going to bed. Keep the noise down, eh? I need some fucking rest.
Come on up. I'll sneak you in the back door.
Wouldn't have it any other way. Nothing like a brisk evening drive to quicken the blood. Except perhaps a single malt McGarren, aged 30 years.
Must be Christmas. Lucky for Jews and me, you came sliding down the chimney when you did.
Christmas, is it? Oh, I'm afraid I've been a bad girl.
Aye, I'm certain of it.
Whatever happened after that weekend in Monaco? You never rang me up.
You never gave me your number?
Oh, that's hardly an excuse. You're not still pining for Jules' little sister, are you? She's a bit of a bore, don't you think?
I don't think I'm her type. So, you in town for the race?
What can I say? I have a weakness for men in fast cars. I've been all over Europe following the circuit. Mum and Dad are mortified, of course.
Beats working for a living.
I wouldn't know.
What's this for? Shaving your legs?
A girl should always carry protection. One day you'll have to tell me how you came by these scars.
We've done enough talking for one night.
Where's the Duchess of York?
Don't know. She was gone when I woke up. To be honest, I feel a bit used.
Oh, my heart bleeds for you. Come on, let's get to the track.
This is your moment, Sean. Remember what I taught you. I trained you to win.
Watch your ass out there. These Nazi bastards are out for blood.
Drivers to starting position.
I'll see you at the victory party.
Broken Grand Prix is underway! to the parking area. Your lights are on.
No, Sean. I forbid
did
it.
Did you not see what that bastard did? The race was mine, Vittori.
Don't go looking for trouble. It finds us all soon enough. It's time we went home. I'll see to the Aurora. Wait for me at the pit.
What's that?
That is where the silver dart will be on display after tomorrow's ceremony.
What ceremony?
In honor of Dioka's victory, the latest triumph of the Aryan race.
Oh, bollocks. It'd be a damn shame if something were to happen to Dioka's car before the big shindig.
You mean some kind of freak accident? Oh, that would be terrible.
Aye, tragic. Who's up for a little Sunday drive?
I'm game.
Where are you two going? Vittore told you to wait here.
We won't be long.
Jules, don't be a fool. If you want to get yourself killed, I can't stop you. But leave my family out of it.
Jules is his own man.
If I may chime in...
It's not polite to eavesdrop. Didn't they teach you that in boarding school?
Quite the opposite, actually.
Perhaps you were too busy screwing your teachers to notice.
Please, we can't all die virgins.
Brother, let's go, Jules.
You're making mistakes, Sean.
When did you become the voice of prudence?
Dirka isn't who you think he is.
Oh, he's not a motherless, arse-faced knob jockey.
He's dangerous, Sean. Let it go.
Thanks for the tip. We'll see you girls later.
Here comes our boy. Let's find out what he's up to.
Oh, just get in the fucking car already.
Don't get too close. We don't want to spook him. Hang back a bit, but don't let him out of your sight.
This isn't the first time I've run a tail, you know.
Sig Motorworks. That place is going to be crawling with crowds.
This scheme of ours could get tricky.
I've heard rumors about that place. Some people say they're making more than cars out there. The head of Doppelsieg has powerful friends in Berlin.
Aye, Karl Eckhart. I saw him at the race with that banshee bodyguard of his.
Franziska, she's one cold bitch. That's the motorworks up ahead.
Let's stash the car and take a closer look.
Over there on the left. Don't want him to see us.
Fancy a little exercise.
I didn't come all the way out here for the view.
Pretty rude of us to drop in without an invitation.
I'm French. I'm supposed to be rude. Come on, let's get over that wall. Looks like a good place to climb over. Where the fuck are you going? Stay out of sight. Give me a boost.
You all right?
Yeah, get over here. How did you learn to climb like that?
Creeping out of bedroom windows at 3 o'clock in the morning.
There's no way I'm letting you dead, my sister. Nice place. They should have a great view of the lake from up here.
There it is. What do you say we take it for a little test drive? Right over that cliff.
You can do the honors. I prefer to watch.
work on my parallel parking.
Maybe we should leave a note, eh?
Dear Wanker, sorry about the bang-up. Send the bill to me arse. Oh, it gives me right arm to see the look on that tosser's face.
That can be arranged, Herr Devlin.
Shite.
Juice! Hold on, Juice! Stay with me! Stop! Stop this! For God's sake, stop hurting him!
Sir!
I'm here, Juice.
For God's sake!
Juice!
Your friend cannot hear you at the moment. I'm afraid the pain was more than he could bear. Francisca tells me you have been eager to see the look on my face. I hope you are not disappointed.
What the fuck is going on here?
Do you believe I spend every waking minute behind the wheel of a race car? I have other, more practical talents with which to serve the Reich. My services are in great demand of late.
Why are you doing this?
I'm a patriot.
You're a fucking animal.
We are all animals beneath the skin. My godfather taught me that. He was a butcher, did you know? He taught me that the flesh holds no secrets once the skin has been removed. I had a long talk with your friend. He sang like a bird. But he could not tell me what I most want to know.
And what is that?
Bishop is not half as clever as he thinks he is. He imagines that we are all blind to his childish schemes. Typical British arrogance.
Who the fuck is Bishop? Maybe you should be talking to him.
Do not insult my intelligence. We know that you are a British agent. We know that you were sent here to conduct surveillance on this facility.
What? You think I'm working for the damn Brits? You must be out of your bloody head.
Enough. You will tell me every operational detail of your mission. You will tell me. One way or another.
Pull your head out of your arse, man. I've got no idea what you're talking about.
Your choice is simple. You may choose to tell me exactly what I want to know, freely and without omission. In which case, you and your friend will return to France to live out the rest of your lives in peace.
Sean.
Or you may refuse.
Are you there?
I'm right beside you, Jules.
In which case, neither of you will ever leave this room. Make your choice. Now.
Go fuck yourself! No! God! You fucking bastard!
Guard the prisoner. The interrogation will continue when I return.
Before this is over, they're gonna wish it hard.
Neuigkeiten vom Farnisch, Herr Eckert?
Der Truppenaufmarsch ist fast beendet. Wir sollten in Kürze den Pers verrufen.
Ich brauche eine Zigarette.
Ja, ich auch. Ich habe keine mehr.
Dann hol welche. Jetzt. Oder du kannst eine Vocal-Latrine in Dienst haben.
We'll be right back.
can't be after me. Something's going down. Something big.
It's an invasion force. God help us all. Those bastards started a war.
You're unharmed, child.
Thanks, Sean. They would have burned me alive.
These men were Gestapo. What are they doing here?
Dierker sent them.
Dierker? Oh my God. Where is my brother? Where's Jules? No! Get away from me! This is your fault! You took him to that place! Jules!
Can't stay here. More Germans will come looking for these.
Where will we go?
West. It's our only chance.
Right. To Paris, then. We'll get you home.
Let's go.
Véronique! Oh, my child! Merci Dieu!
We heard on the radio. The fighting at the border, we were so worried.
I see you brought guests.
These are Jules' friends, Sean and Vittore. They need a place to stay for a while, someplace discreet.
Well, but where is Jules? Did he not come with you?
Mama, something terrible has happened.
Madame Rousseau.
No. No, this can't be happening.
Your son, he was like a brother to me.
No, 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 mon petit fils! No! Mon
cœur! Young man, I must know. My son, Didi, was it quick?
Aye. Quick and painless. Bastard, the killer won't be so lucky.
I took this from the farm. He would want you to have it.
Bonjour, chérie.
Top of the morning, ladies. Over here.
Rad's his way, Michel Depp. The show is about to begin.
I believe you owe me a drink.
But of course, my friend. So, did you see that explosion? Magnifique. Have you ever seen anything burn like it?
Just once, but that was a long time ago.
Well, we're just getting started, my friend. You have a talent for destruction, Sean. I believe we may have found your true calling.
Sean! Oh, please excuse me, Monsieur Godin. I did not know you were acquainted.
We've just met.
It is an honor to meet you, Monsieur.
Please. Call me Luke.
Yes, I have read all your books.
I don't think you're here to discuss literature.
Have you heard about the explosion at the fuel depot?
Aye, nasty bit of business. Somebody must have got careless with a cigarette.
The Nazis are in a fury. They've been arresting suspected rebels. Sean, they took Vittore.
Where?
La Villette. The old slaughterhouse. The prisoners are going to be shot. We must do something.
There is no turning back now.
In for a penny, in for a fucking pound.
Here, take these.
With pleasure.
Let's go then.
Get mixed up in this business.
The Nazis took everything. Our liberty, our pride. I never appreciated what we had till it was gone.
Warplanes.
Bombing Paris.
Bombing German military installations inside the city. My people have been supplying them with target coordinates.
I am afraid we have a problem.
I suppose we've been drinking a wee bit lately. I've been meaning to cut back on the whiskey.
No, I mean your friend does not have much time. La Villette is on the list of British targets.
Christ almighty, we need to get Vittori out.
That's the spot. Pull over. What's the plan?
First, you're going to need a change of clothes.
Come again?
Kill that sentry quietly and take his uniform. Bloodstains will ruin the disguise, so use your hands. Once you're dressed, slip inside the compound through that tunnel. You will need to move fast. The British bombers will be overhead any minute now.
Where will you be?
I will secure the transportation and meet you inside the compound. Now hurry! Go!
lot. I won't even break a sweat.
It's not a great fit, but it'll have to do.
Nein. Betty Grable ist wesentlich hübscher als Eva Braun.
Taking so long! Open this damn door!
Sean, I knew you would come. They were ready to execute us.
How did you get yourself into this mess?
I will explain later. This fight is not over yet.
Sean, look, how bad is it? The bullet won't kill me, but those bombers will kill us all if we don't find cover right now.
How much time do we have?
There is no time. The attack has already begun.
All right. Everyone head for the basement. Now! Move your arses! Downstairs, everybody! Where did you come from?
I followed you here.
I am grateful for that.
When I saw the damage caused by the bombing, it was terrible. I thought everyone had been killed.
What happened?
I stood up when I should have ducked.
Maybe you should stick to writing books. How bad is it?
The wound is filthy. He will need antibiotics.
I'll find a chemist.
Antibiotic supplies are tightly controlled by the German military.
Then I'll go knock up the crowds.
There's a better way. You see that man standing over there?
The one grinning like a cat with a cream-flavored arsehole?
He's called Santos. I've seen him at the Bell. He's a black marketeer. He can get what we need.
I'll go have a chat with him. You're the one called Santos.
Who's asking?
The one who'd stopped these crowds from decorating that wall with your brains. Now you're gonna do me a favor.
Claro que sí. What can I do for you, my friend?
Antibiotics. The heavy stuff.
I see. I can get you what you want, but it won't come cheap. The black market is a barter system. You'll need something to trade for the medicine.
Like what?
Contraband, what else? I sold a rare bottle of champagne to a German officer this morning. Bring the bottle back to me. It's worth a small fortune. To the right people.
Thank you.
Sounds like that tosser's throwing a party. Better grab the bottle before he uncorks it. I need to shake these crowds before I head back to Santos. Nice little village you got here.
You'll be sorry. I am well connected.
Lucky for us, that German major didn't have a chance to open it, eh?
You got the stuff?
I have what you requested right here. They say Santos is like the postal service. Always reliable.
Uh-huh. Cheers.
Momento, Irishman. You are out of a job, no? I might have work for a man with your talents.
Sorry, I'm on holiday.
Then I might have something else that would interest you. When you have finished here, come find me. My place is right across the street from the bell.
I brought the medicine.
Oh, good. The wound has become infected. I will stay till he's back on his feet.
You can't stay here. Come on, I'll take you back to the bell.
No, you will not.
Veronique, I'm just looking out for you, that's all.
The way you looked after Jules. That will not be necessary. No weapons inside, handsome. You can leave them with me.
Anything for you, beautiful.
Merci. You can have them back when you leave.